In many ways, people are learning their theology. They're learning all about God through the songs, you know. Sadly, in many ways, it's not the talks people necessarily remember, but it is the songs, you know. They get in their heads, they sing them in the shower, on the way to work, driving in the car. And so, you know, I guess we have a huge responsibility, which is both exciting but hugely daunting, to fill people with the wonder of all that God is. So I know I've been feeling this need to really be walking closely with theologians, to be getting input from different pastors and teachers. I remember a worship leader friend of mine laying down this challenge. He said, "Tim, if someone comes to your church and they all they do is for 1 month, they just listen to the songs you sing. They don't hear any of the preaching. They don't listen to any of the prayers. They don't hear any of the scriptures read. They just hear the songs. What kind of God would they think that you worship?" Now that's pretty scary, isn't it? So are we using songs that talk about the Trinity, you know, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit? Have we got songs that talk about the transcendence, the otherness of God? Do we have songs about God as creator? Do we have songs about God as friend, as intimate? You know, we kind of, I think in many ways, we've missed out on some songs that talk about that kind of closeness, that drawing near to simply loving God. We can get so technical, we miss on those simple, beautiful moments, you know? So we need to be thinking, how can we bring in all that God is? You know, songs of lament, finding God in place of suffering, songs of intercession, crying out for Him, you know, to come and move and work in power. You know, there's so much to write about, and we mustn't get stuck on a small, narrow picture. And a friend of mine said to me, "Tim, you know, where are the contemporary songs about the resurrection?" And so that got me thinking, and I ended up picking up a book, and I found this quote, this from Michelangelo, the artist, who laid down a challenge to the other artists who were forever depicting Christ in His death. And he said, "Paint Him instead the Lord of life." And I thought, wow, brilliant. So I kind of started to try and find a song that was going to be pure celebration, pure joy, exuberance at the giver of life, and ended up writing the song, "Happy Day. You wash my sins away, I'll never be the same."